Hello and welcome to PDFSupply.com. Today we're going to be talking about how to test a Genius Bus controller. I have here an IC693BEM331. We're going to talk about how to test it. There's two ways that we use to test it and how to configure it in Proficy Machine Edition. So in front of you I have an IC693CHS397 5 slot rack. This is all being powered by an IC693PWR330 power supply, and I'm using as a processor an IC693CPU374+. And some of the other devices I'm going to be using for this test is an IC660BBA020. You don't have to have this specific Genius block, but I'm using this because it has both inputs and outputs, and I'll explain the importance of that shortly. And the other thing I'm going to be using, of course, is the IC660HHM501 handheld monitor. Okay. Now, before we get started with what we're going to do physically to test this, I want to go into Proficy Machine Edition for a moment. I've opened up a brand new file, and I've selected main rack. I've switched it to the CHS397 5 slot rack, PWR330. CPU374+, and in slot number 2, most importantly, the BEM331. So the same physical configuration that you see in front of you is what I've got in the Proficy Machine Edition software. And I've done two configurations, one with slot number 1, the CPU374. If you double click on slot number 1, the tab will pop open so that you can make adjustments to the settings of the CPU. Under settings, and under subcategory parameters, the fourth selection from the bottom is key switch run stop, which activates this so that when you turn the, when the processor is in run mode and you turn it on, it goes into run mode, but you're able to shut it off actually from the processor. And I'll explain that in just a moment. So I've got that set as enabled. And the next thing that I have is the double click on slot number 2 to configure your BEM331. And under device type, for my particular configuration, the way I've configured this with the handheld monitor, the Genius block that is as a 4 analog input, 2 analog output, serial bus address, which is SBA number 1, just for simplicity's sake. So, the first thing that we're going to do to test this is to test the Genius bus controller against or with a Genius block, the BBA020 I had just mentioned and I've already configured. And what I'm going to do that, and I just want to show you my what I've got going on here physically. Currently the block is powered up and it's okay. There's only one LED on. The IO enabled circuit is not on right now. There's a serial cable connection that's terminated with a 150 ohm resistor, but the other end of that serial is in the actual Genius bus controller. So I have, if you look at screws 4 is going to serial 1, and screw 6 is going to serial 2, and again I've got it terminated with a 150 ohm resistor and shielded. My shield cable is on number 16. My shield cable is shield in on the Genius block. So what I've done is I've configured the Genius block using the handheld monitor as serial bus address number 1, or block number 1 in my particular case. And what I'm looking for is two things when I'm using a Genius block for this test. First thing is that when I turn the key into the on position, I should get an IO enabled LED. So this tells me that the Genius bus controller is actually communicating now with the Genius block when I've turned this switch on. I have an IO enabled LED on. The second part of that test, almost more importantly really, is whether the Genius block in my particular case is analog in and analog out. And the purpose of that is that when I touch the analog input with voltage, I should be able to see that voltage going into the, being read through the analog input through my excuse me, my default tables, my analog input tables. So that tells me that I'm able to put a power source here, 0 to 10 volts, and I'm able to see that value go through the Genius bus controller to the Proficy Machine Edition. Then that verifies that that part is working. The other thing I want to do is, of course, the analog output. Can I do the reverse effect? Meaning, am I able to put a value in the analog output table and I'm able to read it through the voltage out of the Genius block itself? And that way I know it can communicate both ways. It can tell the Genius block what to do, and the Genius block can send a signal through the Genius bus controller, the BEM331, to Proficy Machine Edition. So that's the first way to test it, and that's a pretty thorough and complete way to test it. Second way to test it is, I have another prop here for you guys to see. This is from Fanuc Contact. And if you can see on here, type UMK-SE11,25-1. So I've got the same serial connection that we described on the BEM331. I'm using slightly different terminals, but I'm still using serial 1 and serial 2. And then that's connected through this Fanuc contact, which has a 9-pin connector that will go to the handheld monitor. And I'll show you what that's going to do. So we're going to put this on here right now. What I'm hoping to read, what I'm trying to get out of this, once the handheld monitor is connected, is the handheld monitor should be able to read the same exact configuration address and the version, the firmware version, of the Genius bus controller through the handheld monitor. So as you can see, I'm still in run mode, and I have this communication light on and the OK light on, so that tells me that this is a working unit. I'm going to go ahead and turn my handheld monitor on, select OK, and the next thing I want to do is select Analyze, which is F2, and Block Bus Status, F3. Okay, so bus address number 31 and version 1.7, series 90. So that's also another way to test it, to see that it is actually communicating. It's shown me what's actually in the Genius block and in the handheld monitor and the Proficy Machine Edition configuration. So that completes the test, and I'd be satisfied that this is a good working unit with either of these tests, depending on what type of props that you have in order to test, whether it's a Genius block or this Fanuc contact communication circuit that we have made here. Also, of course, you could see that the OK light is on and the communication light is on. A few things that I see that are wrong with these right off the bat would be a unit that you plug in and power up and you don't get any lights on at all, you don't get an OK light. That's a very quick and immediate observation that there's something wrong with the module. Another thing is if you have the processor in run mode and you don't have a communication light, if the communication light is off, that could technically be a problem. And of course, if you do either of the two tests that I described with either the Genius block or the handheld monitor, that and it's not giving you any type of response that there's anything there and communicating, and that's another problem. So this is something that we commonly see and we repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products, and same day shipping. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.